This is a documentation of my journey being someone who's chronically ill.
Just had a meeting with the school and we were talking and we decided that it might be best for me to go home, and I cried and cried and cried and called my mom, and I'm going home. I'm going to Boston from London till Monday.
I'm on my way to St. Pancras to go to Paris to see my sister, and then I'm getting on a flight tomorrow morning. Back to Boston. And I don't know if I'm coming back. I just woke up in Paris. I got here at like 8:30, 9 o'clock last night, 9:30, I think. I don't really remember. Now I was gonna go to the airport and go to Boston.
I miss you so much.
In Boston, I'm back with mom. For the first time in 3 months, I get to see mom. Okay. Unfortunately, it's because I'm dying, but then I'm home. I just have to stay positive and stay happy and
buoyant.
Be grateful that we have the money to get me healthy. Tonight I get to relax, and then tomorrow I go into the doctor's office. 40-minute appointment to determine whether I need to be put under 24-hour watch or the next coming up plans.
Okay.
Home sweet freaking home. Starting to feel sick, and I look sick too. This is the start of healing. This is the start of getting better. I just need to stay positive.
I cannot.
No, through all of this, you have to laugh. You have to laugh.
You were smiling.
And this is the first time I've had any energy to stand up in about 5 hours. And I can't fucking sleep. I've developed like the worst kind of fucking insomnia. I can't sleep. I think I'm scared to go to sleep because I'm scared I'm not gonna wake up. Teeth hurt, my back hurts, I'm exhausted, I'm so tired of being fucking sick. Woke up this morning and couldn't move for 2 hours, but I'm up, I'm dressed, I'm only wearing, this is shocking for me, I'm only wearing comfortable clothes because anything else hurts my body, but I'm gonna try to drive to Starbucks and Walgreens, and I'm gonna do it. And I'm gonna not let my sickness hold me back from being able to live my life.
I don't think I'm supposed to be driving, but I am. And I'm doing my old routine back home, going to Starbucks by my high school, and then I'm gonna go to Walgreens and Trader Joe's. Hi. I'm not allowed to be stressed, so anything that can make me even remotely stressed, I have to not. That even made my thing feel weird. Fucking hell, I'm so sick and I'm so tired of being sick.
Just got a call from the UK and I have a doctor's appointment scheduled on the 18th of April. So I have to get back to London before then. I don't know when I'm gonna come back. I'm not gonna cry. I have a doctor's appointment. I'm not excited. I'm nervous. I'm stressed. I'm anxious.
I'm not allowed to be any of those things, but here we are.
Am I even gonna leave the doctor's office today, or are they gonna fucking keep me? I have no idea what's about to happen. Fuck. I'm in a gown. I'm at the doctor's. I'm getting a physical and my 40-minute meeting done today. Hopefully we get some answers today. Good and bad news. Bad news, there's nothing that they can give me today. And if I have no seizure, I need to go to the emergency room. Not what I wanted to hear, but it's... okay. The second, they're looking into a shot that I can take when I have seizures. They're looking into a nasal spray. I'm finally, somebody listened. So I might have to stay in the States a bit longer than I wanted to, so that I can get all the medicine that I need. Which sucks, but it is what it is. And hopefully I stop feeling so weak and so ill soon. I'm still recovering from my last seizure. I haven't really felt like myself since my last one. But if I have another seizure, 911. I'm getting helped.
Right.
So I can't really hold a camera and I look like shit. But I'm going to hospital. I've had about 5 or 6 seizures. Honestly, probably 8 seizures. My whole body's tingling. I have shortness of breath. I can't see. I can't really hear. I'm trying to stay talking. I have like saliva building up in the sides of my mouth. I thought that I was going to start to feel better. But if anything, today is one of the worst days I've ever felt. I'm not allowed to cry. I have to stay calm. I'm in the emergency room. They gave me Ativan. I'm feeling better, not great. I'm glad I got CAT scan going on. Not a good day. Not a good one. I don't really remember how I got here. I don't really remember what happened. And I'm still not really processing anything about that. But I've woken up today. I haven't tried in 5 days. It's really disgusting, I know, but I think one of the things I didn't realize about being this sick is that your hygiene was out the window. I could barely brush my teeth last night because standing up for that long hurt. But I'm feeling good this morning. It's 9 a.m. Boston time. And I'm feeling really good. I've been trying to go to sleep on time, going to sleep at like 12, waking up at 9. And I'm gonna have a shower. I'm gonna get my mom so that she can sit in the bathroom with me while I take a shower, which sucks. But I'm gonna have a shower, I'm gonna do my hair, and then I'm gonna go through my closet, and then I think I'm gonna go shopping. So I'm feeling really good today, and I think if I eat well, stay positive, and all that kind of stuff, I'm gonna be okay. Okay, so even though I'm feeling terrible, there is one perk of being home, and that's that I get to see my friends. And they've all come and brought me little gifts to make me feel better, and little snacks and candies and everything. So I may be sick, but I'm definitely still feeling the love, and I'm feeling
Raven
supported. No, it's nice. I even when I'm like sick and not able to move and like stuck in bed, they still come and see me. Very nice. I love you guys.
Love you.
I love you guys. Good morning. I am off to neurology today. Okay, I'm driving myself because my parents have this work thing that they've been planning for months and we could Uber, but da da da. I'm driving myself. I'm not really supposed to, but it's fine. I was able to eat a little bit of breakfast this morning, which is a good sign because I usually can't eat breakfast. Feeling a bit nauseous, but nothing crazy. I was able to eat a little breakfast. I don't know the next I'm gonna eat, so I figured I'd eat before I left. I'm nervous. I'm really nervous that they're gonna find something. But also, if they find something, that means that I'm one step closer to curing this damn seizures! These fucking seizures! God, I'm so sick of having them! Like, I try to look put together, and I try to look okay. But I'm really scared. I'm scared all the time. I'm constantly worried something's gonna happen to me.
And I really try to like hide it with partying and going out and raving and mask it all with that life. And being here is just really, being back home in Boston has really made me realize like, I've just been hurting myself. I made it. I got 2 minutes, so I gotta go in. So I'm just blasting some music to make myself feel better. Really nervous. Today, hopefully, let's see some results.
I know that if I get too stressed out, I'll seize. So it's just about maintaining a level of calmness.
What the fuck? Ah! What the fuck?
So I just pulled into my driveway. I'm going to the hospital. Journey's not over yet. Thought that maybe it'd be done today, but no. I'm going to hospital and I'm gonna get an EEG done where they put all the wires on your head and all the heart monitors and they induce a seizure. And I was told that the oxygen and everything isn't really gonna help and all these little medications that they wanna give me. Oh fuck, I need to go to Walgreens. But no, like all these little medications that my doctor wanted to give me that I was so excited about finally getting something are not really gonna help, because if they are stress induced and my brain isn't doing the brain thing, what the fuck is a seizure gonna medication? Like, what is that gonna do? All it's gonna do is nothing, because I'm not having that kind of seizure. So this is really good. This is a really good step forward. But I'm not going back to London for a few more days. I just want it to be over. I just want it to be done. I want to go back to my fucking life. But I know that when they find out what's wrong and they find out what's hurting me, when I go back to London, I'm gonna be able to party and be with my friends and go out to dinner and go shopping and go to class and do my fucking homework. I can't do my fucking homework. I'll get too stressed out. So I'm gonna do it in the hospital. When they need to induce a seizure. Great. I love being this sick. I can't wait to be in the hospital for the next few days. I can't fucking wait. I'm so excited. I'm so sick of this.
I'm packing. Or the hospital. I got, I'm not sure how many clothes I'm supposed to bring, but I've got clothes and deodorant and a little bit of makeup in case I feel like putting some on, and just a few little things. And I've been sitting here crying for a while. God, I'm so embarrassed. I'm going alone tomorrow. And then that's fine. And I keep saying this, but I told myself that I'd be honest in this. And I wanna hold to that. One of the big things I found about being sick is letting people down. I knew I needed to get my health together sooner. I just didn't want to, I didn't care enough about myself, honestly. I didn't care enough about myself or how, what happened to me to deal with it, but then I realized how many people cared about me getting better, and now I'm getting the help, and I'm so grateful to have met these amazing people that want me to get better. And that made me realize I want to get better because I like living. And part of the reason I put off getting better for so long
because I was scared. I was scared of what they'd find. And now, I'm heading into tomorrow. Alone. And I don't blame anyone for that. My parents have a workshop. Like, I'm not gonna make them miss it because of, like, their sick daughter. And I know. Oh my god, I can hear people telling me already. No, no. Da 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 da. I don't give a fuck anymore. I've caused them so much money. And so much pain. And suffering. I need to grow up. And be an adult about this. And go to this appointment tomorrow alone. Deal with it. I just need to deal with it. And I'm kicking myself. Because I wish I would have gotten my health together sooner. I didn't. Because of this right here, I'm packing for a hospital visit. And I don't know how it's gonna go. And I know I already said this, but I have a lot of trauma from, like, not knowing how doctor's appointments are gonna go. And I'm so scared they're never gonna let me out. This time I'm really scared I'm not gonna be let out. So, I'm mentally preparing to be trapped in a room. I'm preparing to have wires and shit hooked up to me. Well, I have to go through one of the most dramatic experiences of my life. I don't know if I'm gonna make it out of these seizures half the time, and I don't want to tell people that because I didn't want to scare them even more, but half the time I don't think I'm gonna make it out. And now I have to do it in a room full of strangers. I just want to be healthy and normal. I've been sick for 7 years straight. And I think that means I'm chronically ill. I'm not. I'm like a scared little kid. I can do this. It really doesn't feel like I can. I can. And I just need to keep telling myself that I can and hearing my friends and my family tell me that I can do this and just repeating it. Because I'm so scared. I'm so scared. I want to be a normal teenager. I want to go party. And I want to go to dinner. I want to go to dinner without people scared that I'm going to die. I want to go shopping and go to markets. And I tried to do that, but I just put myself at risk. And now I don't know if I'm ever going to be normal again.
She said it's only 45 minutes, so I guess it's quick. Okay, so basically that was just to see if I don't have epilepsy. We know I don't. I don't know what the fuck that was for. I think it was just to, like, make sure that there's nothing weird happening with my brain that could be related to epilepsy. I think that's what that was for. But now I still have to wait to get admitted to Leahy. So, glad that I packed a bag because I'm hopefully going in today. I'm going. I'm going. Okay, so they've put pads along the beds in case I have a seizure so I don't hurt myself. They've hooked me up to this heart monitor thingy. I don't know if it's on or not. This is where I'm gonna be for the next little while, I guess. I'm not allowed to get out of bed. An alarm will sound. If you have a bed alarm. Even if I want to get something from my stuff. Sound. I can't pee without a nurse in the room. Nothing. Yeah. This is all about getting better.
Michael. Well, I was there for 12 years. Get out, Michael. It's so good.
Hi. So, I'm hooked up to the EKG now. I woke up and they put it on me. And I have another pouch. That's the EKG stuff, and put new batteries in my heart monitor, and the doctors came in and talked to me, and today I need to have a seizure. They were like, how can we stress you out? And I was like, I don't do my homework. So I'm gonna do my homework. I've got 15 designs to do, and I missed my meeting because I was in the hospital doing all that, and there's calls I need to make, and I'm already stressed out, so that I guess that's a good thing. I feel very sick today, not in the like coughing, I just feel like the wires and the stuff. I just feel very sick. Talking to this camera makes me feel less lonely. Really sad.
All right, all the pineapple.
Now
it doesn't look like much.
I
thought you broke up with her.
Here you are. How's it going?
Good. I just had some pizza, which hopefully stressed me out. I had some tiramisu penne tonne. That was so good. Dad, you should try some.
Dad's eating the cake. Mommy, gonna try any of the penne tonne cake?
No.
Love you guys. Thanks for coming. Bye, guys.
Peace
out. Love you.
Hello. An update. I did it. I had two seizures. I did homework to stress myself out and called people to stress myself out. My parents came and I did it. I had two seizures. They weren't very big ones, so I'm staying up late to make me tired and have my body crash. But I did it. I had two seizures. And now we wait for more.
I feel like I'm going crazy. It's almost 6 a.m. and I wasn't getting melatonin, so of course I didn't sleep, and I've been laying in this damn bed. I'm so bored.
I think I'm gonna get to go home soon. I did it. I want my periods, my back pain is really, really bad. When I came out of my seizures, the only thing I remember is being in extreme amounts of pain. And oh, that also sent me into a seizure. I think things are looking up. I think I'm gonna get to go home soon. I get to go home. I don't know, I guess like it does get better. And I didn't believe that. Oh my god, I didn't believe that. But it gets better. There's one person that got fucking better, it's me. It gets fucking better. I could cry.